The Olympics to me, I mean, I've always been thinking about the Olympics since I could even think about being a professional athlete. The Olympics is everything to me. Being that I've gone to one Olympics already, my mind has shifted because I feel like that first Olympics was, oh my gosh, I'm an Olympian. I can call myself an Olympian. I've reached all these goals and dreams and aspirations of being an Olympian. Now it's about medaling and getting gold medal at the Olympics. And I don't know, I feel like that is a whole nother dream that I'm dreaming.
I'm getting old. I can feel it. 10 days away from 25. That's enough for the day. I quit. Oy.
I think it's important to show everything because it's like a reality check. I feel like people think that we're these superstars and the powerful athlete and power couple, but we are two humans at the end of the day. And I feel like this honestly is the best way to show it, is that, you know, I don't show up 110% every single day with the mind of that I'm going to win the Olympics or with the attitude and determination that I want, that I am the best. I think people have their bad days, and I think sharing the good, the bad, and the ugly is the most perfect thing to do. We get wrapped up in just trying to show the best of the best. And I love showing that I'm not okay all the time. I love showing that relationships are crazy. You know, I enjoy doing that because I know there's someone out there that can relate. And I feel like when I was younger, there was a lot that I couldn't relate to about people. And just showing my authentic self, whatever that comes up as, is a movement in itself. Not every day is okay, and not every day is great. And I love showing that. I love showing the authenticity of the Woodholes. He's a big girl.
Coming off a meet week, and it's the first week we started the taper, so usually in the off weeks is when I feel the worst, oddly enough. Are you okay, baby?
No, my knees hurt.
She's deep in the cycle right now. So everything just hurts. It's that part of the season.
So we are in our second cycle of the outdoor season. We just finished our first opener. I jumped 23.6, which is about 7:16 in meters. Hunter, my husband, he just opened up in the 400, ran 46.3 and split 44.8. I have a really relaxed day. Personally, Hunter does not. He's going to Japan. We're gonna ship him off to Japan. See ya. Sayonara.
That's what's happening. I leave tomorrow morning at 8 a.m. Out of here.
Can I help you?
No.
All right, so watch it.
Watch what?
In my shot. He's trying to get an aesthetic look right now. Yeah, I mean, being a professional athlete is not easy. It's a constant sacrifice of everything I do, every step I take, every activity I do, everything I put in my body, just to get to this one point in my life. And like, I'm totally okay with that, but people don't realize that this is truthfully a job, a 24/7, 7 days a week job. I mean, it's totally fine that people don't understand because that they're not in the sport doing it. Like, there's only so many people that can actually commit themselves to being dedicated as a track athlete or an athlete in general. There's more to it than just those couple seconds on the screen.
All right, let's go do this workout. I'm tired. Today's one of those mentally tough days. But we're here. And we're gonna get it done. Because I want to be number one. Bye-bye.
I guess it gets hard to share when either things aren't going your way or when it starts to feel like a job. And that's when I probably go MIA, when I start to feel like everything I do is a job. Most difficult part is when you don't want to share the hardest moment of whether it be losing or, I don't know, just a mentally tough day. And you just don't want to see yourself in that light. But then when you put it out there like that, you get these comments like, oh my gosh, I wasn't having the best day, or you get the DMs of like, how do you deal with like not wanting to show up that day or not wanting to be motivated that day? And honestly, I don't know. I don't know, but the only thing that you can do is just to show up. And once you show up, you never know where that's gonna take you. I've had plenty of practices where I don't wanna be there, but once I've shown up, like my whole entire day has turned around. So just showing up and giving yourself a chance is the easiest way to get around the feeling of not wanting to be there.
I'm ready for this to be over. SeaWorld Athletics tries an always happy, smiley, go get him attitude.
Try to smooth out your deceleration a little bit. You were going so fast.
You were like absolutely rolling though.
Get your workout done.
I'm getting ready to go.
I don't need your criticism today.
It's not criticism. Constructive criticism. I see how that sounds. You're doing great.
Right now it's just like your head's down, you're just grinding. And I feel like each practice right now is more of a mental toughness rather than a physical toughness. I just came off of World Indoor Championships, winning that in the long jump, which is pretty awesome. But the main focus this year is obviously the Olympics, so we're gearing up for outdoor right now. Opener jump 716, which is an outdoor PB, which is super, super good. Means that my training's going super well, actually. Way better than I could ever freaking imagine. When I'm in competition, I just feel more like myself. When I'm just like walking on the street, I'm super chill, I'm super like, I don't know, normal, at ease, at peace. But like when I'm on the runway, that's where I get to be my most unhinged and get to be my most like, I don't really care what people are thinking about me right now. I get to do what I love to do, and that's jumping far and running fast. This season I had an Achilles strain, and it didn't stop me from working out. It didn't stop me from getting rehab or recovery or doing the things that I know that can put my body in the best position it can be in. Right now, I feel a little banged up, but I'm gonna go home and, you know, do an ice bath and make sure I roll out and just like get those recovery tools in, because that's probably what I'm lacking.
We just got back home from the track, and as you can see, I'm much happier because I'm at home. We actually start cooking every day. We cook. It is a constant mess in the house because we're always cooking. So today we're cooking some sweet potatoes, eggs, and ground beef. We're making like a little bit of a hash. When I think about home, this is literally what I think about. I think about my dogs. I think about the privacy and the comfort that I have. I feel like I'm a homebody more than people probably realize. I am an extrovert, but I love, love being at home. It's just like my sanctuary with all of my plants and my children running around. I have peace here. We travel so, so, so much that when I come home, I can like just kind of turn off. I am so myself out on the track, but a lot of people think I'm like probably this energetic when I'm at home, and I'm not. Yeah, I just think of home as my safe space.
Getting a little chunky. He's well fed.
Pasture-raised eggs. These are some happy chickens.
Happy chicks. I've stayed out of the kitchen for like way too long now, so I'm just gonna let Hunter do his job. He's the wife around here.
Eggs just like don't co-expire, right?
They do.
But
they
like,
do expire.
It's a long time, right? I've had these eggs for a while, but I'm pretty sure they're good.
Used by May 19th, 2024.
Oh, we're good. Tara will only eat scrambled eggs. I should make sure this isn't expired. May 31st, we're good. I love sweet potatoes, I love beef, and I love eggs.
My favorite thing to cook is white chicken chili soup, truthfully.
Mm. You make some mean pasta too?
I do make a mean pasta. I used to like making salmon all the time.
You make good salmon too.
Recently, I've been kicked out of the kitchen.
No, that's not true.
Hunter's been cooking recently because he knows what he wants. When I was cooking, I knew what I wanted.
You're saying you don't want the things that I want?
Sometimes I want unhealthy pasta and cream-loaded pasta. Creamy loaded pasta.
That's fair.
I think Hunter sprints to the kitchen to cook food.
That's not true. Oh boy. It's poor you.
If we're near the water, sushi's the only thing we'll eat for days. If we're probably like 2 meals a day, forever how long that we're there, we're eating it every single day.
Yeah, and like a lot of sushi.
I honestly don't think I would be in this sport the way I'm in this sport if it wasn't for him. Every day it's a grind, and I am lucky enough to have someone who's also in the same sport and the same mindset and life. So I definitely would say Hunter is my inspiration. And I think I've been saying that since we started dating, and it's honestly the truth. If he can do it, I can do it. Come here, you toads! Oh, get him!
I'm excited for fans and my family to be out there, and especially Hunter, since he wasn't allowed to come to Tokyo. I'm super, super stoked for him to be at the Paris Olympics. We're just gonna do what we do.
Yep.
Normally, when one of us is competing, you know, just support each other, be there for each other. Most likely gonna end up getting like a residency in freaking Paris. That's how long we're gonna be staying for. But I'm just super, super stoked for both of us to be there for each other. Tokyo was really, really hard. I think I left 24 hours after I competed in Tokyo, and I came home and he was home, and then we switched. So both of us in Paris, it's gonna be a dream. It's gonna be a movie.
When a track athlete has like these crazy accolades, I feel like they get lost in from the athlete and then from the person. And I made it a very big priority of myself is to like be able to separate those two. Because when I come home, not that I don't want to talk about track or want to watch track, but I want to like embrace the other side of life. I'm still only 25 years old and I'm still young, and I still have so much more life to live rather than focusing 24/7 on track and field. If there is a young girl out there and you're following me, don't let someone else's thought and opinion about you dictate your life. I feel like a lot of us are looking at other people's life and wishing that they could be that person, but you're your own person for a reason. And I feel like, yes, you can take away inspirations from people, but be your own self. Don't ever give up on yourself. Live your life to the fullest and have fun.
I'm so proud of you.